20 years, who is a king maker for more than 6,700 aspirants who are serving the nation into various central and state government services like IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS, DYSP, Tahsildar, PSI, PDO, sub-registrar and many more. He is the man behind the unique platform for the students to achieve civil service examinations at their young age by joining Universal Group of Institutions, which is an integrated college offering undergraduate courses with integrated training for IAS, IPS and KAS. And also we have BA LLB with IAS, a unique platform in Pan India with the first institution, Universal Group of Institutions, the first institution offering BA LLB with IAS. That is a 5 years integrated course. So we welcome you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, so Upendra sir, you can go ahead.
Dear students, see, today our Kaushik sir is there. Afterwards, sir, Nalini will introduce you. He is the IAS examination topper of this year. He will guide you how to prepare and what kind of the concept of our college, how it is help you to go for the service in your younger age, like 23, 24 years. He will guide you what kind of preparation and other things. Then you can discuss with him. You can ask all your questions and other things. You can send your questions through the chat box. One thing. The first of all, I once again, through digital, I welcome you for this seminar as a chairman of Universal Group of Institutions. See, and also those who are some are already, I think, joined students also here, and some are to join. Anyhow, you are getting a lot of information about our college. One Mr. Harsha is also available. He is also able to ask some more questions about the college or college administration or some other things. Sir is going to answer, Kaushik sir is going to answer for your anxiety, what kind of the things you have for the preparing and other things. Okay. See, first I want to tell you one, two words. See, why we start this kind of institute. It's a different kind of the institute compared to any other institute or college. Why means is so simple. We have a 20 years, 21 years experience in this civil service training. After the graduation, after post-graduation or after engineering, medicine, MBA, MA, BA, BCom. Afterwards, there are so many aspirants are coming for the coaching to become a civil servant. See, the afterwards also you required 2-3 years to prepare for this examination. This examination is not a difficult, but it's a different style of the examinations. Because of that, we thought, why not we have to go for this kind of college along with the degree. See, whenever, anyhow, you have to do degree anywhere in your native place or Bangalore or out of stations or anywhere you have to, Delhi or anywhere you have to go for degree to write this examination. That may be BCom or LLB or BA or BSc or engineering, anywhere. See, when you are going for degree itself, if you study for along with the degree and for the civil service examinations, it examinations is become easy and it is become cakewalk for you. And also you can go as early as possible, matlab almost all age of 23, 24 or 22, you can go for this service. You are getting a more number of service. If you're getting more number of service, you can go for the key posts like chief secretaries and cabinet secretary or IG and DG or commissioner of police. This type of post, key posts, you can go for that. This is the main idea. This is behind this, our new concept. Fourth year for this concept. Once again, you are heartily welcome. I'll hand over my things to the Mr. Kaushik. Kaushik, you also all the best once again within digital distinctions, and also you're heartily welcome for this seminar. Thank you so much. Nalini, please introduce her.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir. Sir, I have already said we have Kaushik sir, Mr. Kaushik HR, who was born at Sringeri Koppa, basically an engineering graduate, and who also was working at one of the renowned IT company, and also had got job opportunities in abroad. But still, besides that, he chose civil services as his future goal, and finally he achieved the 240th rank in last UPSC results and secured the IRS, Indian Revenue Services posting. And recent UPSC results, he have achieved 380th rank for the second time. I mean, first time was 240th rank, and now to 338th rank. And now he's expecting IRS, IAS posting, Indian Administrative Services posting. And we are honored to introduce him on this platform, who was also one of our alumni students, and also a trainer, mentor, motivator, supporting hand, and whatnot. We welcome you, sir. And yes, sir. And the mic is yours. Yeah.
Thank you. And thanks to the UPSC, I mean, Universal Growth Institution, and Lokendra Shetty, sir, for having such a beautiful platform where I can interact with all young minds, I think, all targeted audience are 10th and 12th pass out students. So it will be great to interact with such energetic bunch of people. So, but myself, as Naveen introduced very beautifully, yes, I am with UCC from many years. First, I was a student at the University in the Coaching Center, Vijayanagar. Way back when I was working in an IT company, settled abroad, and when I came back, when I wanted to pursue UPSC preparation, immediate thought that came to my mind is Universal Coaching Center, which is in Nathigupe, Vijayanagar. I joined their program because I didn't know anything about UPSC. When I was there, I didn't know anything about UPSC preparation. I think Nalini, even there are people outside Karnataka, so it's better I address in English. I think many, you know.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I continue with English. Okay.
Only few.
Okay, fine. So if someone doesn't care, Arthagila Kannadali, again, you can. I know both the languages, so not a problem. If someone wants me to speak in Hindi, we'll discuss later. So basically, when I didn't know anything about UPSC preparation, at that time the thought came was Universal Coaching Center. So I got the proper guideline about how to approach this exam, because as Shetty sir already mentioned, this exam is it's not difficult. It may be a little difficult, but why it becomes very difficult is because this exam is very different. The way we approach this exam has to be totally different, not like your how you study for 10th, 12th, or how you study for degree. This exam is not like that. This exam approach is totally different. It's more of knowledge-based, more of application-based. What you study, how you apply it. Those things I understood, and later, yes, this was my fifth attempt. In the fourth attempt, I secured a rank 240. This attempt, I am presently in Indian Revenue Service, Assistant Commissioner, GST and Customs. And this year, I secured a 380 rank, and all thanks to the new reservation, I'll be getting into Indian Administrative Service this year. So my whole point about this model, Shetty sir was explaining, I'm with them from the blueprint of this model. When they had planned to open this college itself, I'm there with them as a guiding factor. I'm a strong supporter of this model. Why, Andre? Because see, for example, by the time now I'm entering Indian Administrative Service at the age of 30, so I can never become a chief secretary, cabinet secretary, because I get, usually it is in the government sector, it's always based on your seniority experience. Whereas you guys imagine, and always remember, as we start getting the age, somewhere our energy will go down. Whereas when you are studying for UPSC, when you are in degree itself, the best advantage will be in the degree, as per every degree, any degree, science, arts, commerce, whatever you take, you get a lot of free time, quite natural. Unfortunately, what we end up is we bunk the class, go for movie, all those things we do. Youthful age is well and good. We waste those time. Whereas in this model, when you're studying along with degree, you will not waste those time, and instead of that, use it in the right direction. So in the 3 years, if you focus on your UPSC preparation, by the time you come out of degree 21, 22 years, you'll be ready to write the exam, and you can become a very young IAS, IPS officer, whatever is your dream. At 21, 22, if you become, imagine you'll get a career of 36, 37 years of career you will get. So you can become top bureaucrats in the country, like maybe cabinet secretary, IBA head, like Ajit Doval sir, or DGP of the state. All those positions, you need a lot of experience, more than 30 years of experience. One more thing is, during college days, you'll be very much having a lot of energy. That is the age, what we call it as adolescent age, like 18 plus. That is the age where we'll have a lot of energy. And a lot of distractions also. So when you're focused on UPSC preparation, you'll not have any such distractions, and all your energy will be focused on UPSC preparation. So at the young age, imagine when I didn't even know what is this UPSC, you can become an IAS officer. So that is why this model is very helpful, because you'll be studying at a very young age. You can write exam at 21 or 22, and you can become an officer by 22 or 23. It may be any service you go, you can go to the great height, the highest position in the country for a bureaucrat. You can achieve that position. That is why this model is very beneficial. So I would like to wish you all to take good use of this model and come out with flying colors.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay. So we also have Mr. Harsha, who holds engineering graduation and a former software engineer, who is an alumni student of Universal Coaching Center and aspirant of civil services. Twice he cleared SSC CGL exams and also serving at Universal Group of Institutions as Dean Academics, who is giving more and more of innovative ideas and all those. So over to you, sir. You can brief about Universal Group of Institutions, the courses, what we are offering, the new idea, what we have come up with, and all those. Harsha, sir, over to you.
Hi everyone. Good evening. First of all, I would like to tell that it's my pleasure that I'm sharing the platform with Kaushik sir, who is my mentor too. And thank you, Nalini ma'am, as well as Upen Shetty sir, who is the chairman, who has brought in this idea, this beautiful idea about the civil services at a very young age. See, as Kaushik sir pointed out, I would like to tell you a small, situation where I was in once. Okay. See, when I was in the final year of my engineering, what happened is, see, me and a few of my friends wanted to know about the civil service examinations. Okay. See, first of all, we got exposure in the final year of our engineering. First point. Second thing is, we wanted to know about civil services, but there was no sources. Okay. So I'm not talking about some decade old. Okay. I'm not that much, senior. I'm just talking about 2014-15. At that time, there was no resources. I still remember, I went to a cyber cafe, because at that time, nowadays, see, you guys are watching through the internet, and internet facility is so easily available. At that time, not even internet facility was not available. I still remember, we used to recharge 250 rupees, 2 GB, that too per month, not per day. Okay, per day, now you guys are using 2 GB, but that is for per month. So we used to go for cyber cafe. When I typed UPSC Civil Services Examinations, there was a lot of confusing, articles regarding civil services. Like some articles used to tell that there are two optional, some articles used to tell that there is one optional. So finally, to understand the examination itself, I took one whole year just to understand the pattern itself. Okay. And I do not hail from some, rural background. I come from a district called Davangere, which is actually a district. Now it is a smart city. Just imagine in a district like small city, this is a situation. Just imagine a country like India. Got it. So now the situation is changed. 2-3 years, the situation is completely changed, where, people started thinking about civil services at the very young age, even from PU, from graduation, at the very young age. The thing is, why this course is not actually that much fascinated or that much in news is because, I'll tell you a simple concept. Like, if you want to become an engineer, what will you do? You will finish your PUC science and you will write a CET or IIT JEE examination. You become an engineer. So if you want to become a doctor, what will you do? You will PUC science again, write your CET, that is NEET. Now this time it is NEET, then it was CET. Now it is NEET, you write NEET. If qualify, then obviously you are going to become a doctor. Now what if you want to become a civil servant at a very young age? Fine. See, that is where, the guidance is not properly available. What if you want to become a government servant at a very young age after graduation? See, that is where you need to take those subjects which overlaps with the syllabus, which overlaps with the preparation of your government examinations, especially civil services examinations. Civil services in the sense IAS, IPS, KS, all these comes under civil services. Now, what subject exactly overlaps? Obviously, history, geography, economy, as well as polity. See, these are the four subjects with the newspaper, that is current affairs. Pillar for the civil service examinations. Okay. So if you don't have grip on these four subjects, then I don't think one can clear the civil service exams. One can become IAS or KAS. So now I think everybody knows here in this platform that where these four subjects comes in degree. In your graduation, which graduation Can anybody answer me now in a chat box? Tell me which graduation gives you these four subjects? ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಗ್ರಾಜುಯೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ? ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತಾ? ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಜಿಯೋಗ್ರಫಿ, ಇಕನಾಮಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓದ್ತೀರಾ ನೀವು? ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓದ್ತೀರಾ? ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿ ಎ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಎಲ್ ಎಲ್ ಬಿ. ಫೈನ್. ಸಿ, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಗೈಸ್ ಕೆನ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಫಿನಿಶ್ ದ ಸಿಲಬಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿ ಆಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್, ಓಕೆ, ವಿತ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಓರಿಯಂಟೇಷನ್, ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಓರಿಯಂಟೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. See, you will be trained for a degree in the morning, 10 to 1 o'clock you will be having a degree classes. In the afternoon, that is from 1 hour, they will be having a lunch break. From 2 to 4 or 5, you will be having classes for civil service examinations. Only for IAS examinations, you guys will be having classes, which covers history, geography, economy, polity, environment, science and technology, all these subjects. Okay, very good. Tejamulya, very good. Jagat Krishna, yes, everybody recognize it correct. It is B. Fine. So now, this is what is the course. Okay. And the second important thing here is, after your classes, you will be having a study hours. Okay. That is 2 hours of study hours in the evening, as well as 2 hours of study hour in the morning. Fine. 79, you will be having study hours in the morning. Evening, 6 to 8, you will be having study hours. As well as in between classes will commence and regular current affairs classes will also happen. Fine. So this is way. This is the way how we have kept our orientation towards civil services. So our aim is that after your 3 years of graduation, you must be completely fit to write civil service examinations. Fine. This is the idea behind the college, the Universal Group of Institutions. And yes, I think you guys are, you know, like pretty much excited to speak with Kaushik sir and ask many doubts with Kaushik sir. So I would not take much time regarding this. But yes, I would like to tell you one thing. Start early, as sir told you, because starting early gives you a lot of benefits than your peers. Okay. For example, those your if your friends are taking medical and engineering, if they want to start, they'll start after 4 years or 5 years. Okay. By that time, you would have already become officer or you would have already completed the syllabus. Okay. So that is what I would like to tell you. And I would like you guys to, you know, like ask the questions, as well as I would like Kaushik sir to add some more, like any more points that he wants to add. Sir, over to you.
Okay. Yes, Harsha said, what is the advantage in most of the options which you offer? Like, if I'm not wrong, BA, BCom, and law is the options which the college offers. As Harsha already pointed out, see, most what we say as basic foundation of any competitive exam, civil service exam, are the four subjects: history, geography. I call it as always four pillars whenever I teach: history, geography, polity, and economy. There is only, like, for example, in commerce you cover a few aspects, especially in arts you cover most of these aspects. In the law, you cover most of these aspects. So that is one advantage. For general studies, you can focus a lot. And also, most of the time, what will happen is selecting an optional. I don't know if you're aware about the exam pattern. We'll discuss that later. Optional, you need to select one subject, an optional subject, and you'll have two papers, totally 500 marks. You'll get from optional. That is like do or die, the most important thing which you have to do. See, for example, like I'm an engineer, telecom engineer, and I think even Harsha is an engineer. Like, we both have selected political science is optional. See, what will happen is, somewhere I'm not very comfortable with my engineering knowledge because I was working 3 years, that knowledge was not well established. So what usually the best way to do is take some graduation subject, which many, many people will fail. But for humanities optional, or for this thing, you can easily take the optional whichever you have studied for 3 years. So for me, it's like studying political science for a science student who doesn't know anything about that. It took me almost 2 years to get a complete proper grip about this subject. So imagine for you guys, you would have completed a degree on it. It's almost equivalent to somewhere little higher than BA syllabus, you can say. Little higher than bachelor syllabus in optional subjects. So that will also help you a lot. You can easily select one of your graduation subjects as optional, and that will also get you good marks. So overall, that is why if you start studying from the graduation days itself, it will help you in your preparation, it will help you in your optional. So, and also at a very young age, you can become an officer. That is the whole idea behind this institution. Thank you. So, what do you, Nalini?
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
So basically, as sir told that, yes, I'm also from engineering background. I see in 2003, I actually have a patent in my name, so which is called as a smart two-wheeler. Okay. See, what happens is the same thing as sir told. My optional was electrical engineering, because I was always thinking that anyways, I have completed electronics and communication. Since there is no electronics optional, so I took electrical engineering. Fine. So now the thing is, it didn't work out because having electrical engineering as an optional subject and you're competing with those people who are coming from IITs, PhDs, it was very tough. Now think, I have changed the optional subject from political science, and definitely, as I told you, that is why Kaushik sir, as I have mentioned you, he is my mentor. So definitely it would require me another 1 year or 1.5 years of time to, you know, I need to toil in the political science optional subject, and I need to get 12 hours in that subject. So obviously 1.5 to 2 years of time. So this I wanted to share you that, you know, if you start early and preparing your optional subject as well as your general studies, then that would be a, you know, a better choice. And yes, as the chairman sir has joined, and I would like sir to add some few more points.
I think the students are quite interesting about hear Mr. Kaushik's speech. I don't want to disturb them, but I think they have a lot of anxieties or some other things. It's better Kaushik speak half an hour onwards. We'll go for some questionnaire and other things. That's why Kaushik, better you discuss with them 30 minutes or something, then we'll answer their questions. Okay.
I think we'll firstly, most of you will not be aware of what is this exam. I'll briefly explain you what is this exam, how this exam is conducted, what you are supposed to know, all those things. So basically, when we call UPSC exam, UPSC exam, it's actually not UPSC exam. UPSC is like the HR agency of every company. It's like recruitment body of the union government. So Union Public Service Commission. Similarly, for the state government, we have Karnataka Public Service Commission. Every state will have their own public service commission. This exam, what we call a civil service examination, it will be for multiple service, around 24 services, will be a single exam, because many people have this misconception. Presently, it is only a single exam, one exam for around 20, 24, 25 services. Like all the top services, IAS, IPS, Foreign Service, then you have Revenue Service, Account Audit Service, all these services, there is only one examination that is called, we call it a Civil Services Examination. So how it happens is, usually every year UPSC will release a notification saying that what, how many posts are there, how are we recruiting those things. Usually in the month of February they release. Usually the prelims will happen. There are three stages in the Civil Services Examination. The first stage we call it as Preliminary Examination. Second stage is Mains Examination, and then we call it as Interview. Officially we call it as Personality Test. Usually prelims happen somewhere in the month of June or July. This year it's been delayed because of this COVID pandemic. It's not usually it happens in the time, you know, from June. Next year it will again be in the June. Mains will happen somewhere in September, October, that time. Then finally interview accordingly. So in the prelims, prelims is actually qualificatory, which means to get a rank, your prelims score will not matter. But to write mains, the next stage, you have to qualify prelims. In prelims, you'll have two papers. The first paper, we call it as general studies paper, and one more paper, we call it as CSAT, Civil Services Aptitude Test. See, the CSAT is not like, well, how much are you scoring CSAT won't matter. You just have to score a minimum marks of 67. If you score 67 marks, or if you score 200 marks, it will not make any difference. But if you don't score 67, you cannot write mains. Even if you score full on full in the GS paper, it won't matter. So it is qualificatory. Whereas general studies paper marks will decide whether you will be writing mains or not. General studies, you'll have, in CSAT, you'll have 80 questions for 200 marks, which means one question is of 1.5 marks. And general studies, you'll have 100 questions for 200 marks, which means one question is of 2 marks each. So general studies paper, the marks you score in general studies paper, GS paper, will decide whether you'll be writing mains or not. In general studies, you will cover all the basic subjects like history, geography, polity, economy, environment, art and culture, what all we study. The questions will appear from all these subjects. Totally, there will be 100 questions. And every year, based on the competition, how many people write, how many vacancies are there, few people will write. See, lakhs of people will apply, lakhs of people will write mains. In that, thousands of people will write, I mean, lakhs of people will write prelims. See, usually around 4 to 5 lakh people will write prelims, and amongst them only 10,000 to 15,000, depends on the number of vacancy. Those many people will write mains. Prelims is objective, which means like MCQ, ABCD options, both CSAT and GS paper, and there will be negative markings. 1/3 of the marks per question you will lose. Whereas mains is totally subjective, like essay type, what you call subjective, which means in mains, there are 4 general studies paper, GS 1, 2, 3, 4. GS 1 will be about history, geography, art and culture, Indian society. Then GS 2 is all about Indian polity, that is Constitution of India, international relations. You have social development, those aspects. GS 3 is very vast, like economy and economy associated, like industrialization. You have banking, environment. Then you have security, internal security, disasters, all those things. GS4 is a unique paper where they are checking your morality, ethics, morality, that paper. 4 GS paper, which is common for everyone. And there is 1 essay paper. In all these 4 GS paper, usually on an average, there will be 20 questions. Totally, every paper will be for 250 marks. In the mains, all the papers will be for 250 marks. So whatever you score in this mains will decide whether you will get a rank or not, will decide whether you will give interview or not. So there are 4 GS paper, as I told. And there is 1 essay paper. In essay paper, you are supposed to write 2 essays. 1 essay will give 125 marks. So it's not like your school exams where we write. Even I have written like essay, I used to write for 10 marks. Freedom moment means I used to write 5 lines about freedom fighters' name itself. Such things will not work in UPSC exam. You have to write an impactful essay. That will be for 125 marks each. You are supposed to write 2 essays, totally 250 marks. Then there is very key aspect is, you have to select 1 optional. There are multiple list of subjects which you can select as optional, which UPSC have a list. You have to select 1 subject as optional. I'm telling you, optional syllabus will be a little vast. It will almost be a little higher than your bachelor's degree subjects, almost close to MA syllabus. So in optional, there again be 1 subject, but 2 papers. Each paper is of 250 marks. So optional alone will get you 500 marks. So these are the 7 papers which will decide whether you will become an officer or not. If you score very high in it, then you will go to interview. And again, later that I'll tell you about interview. There are 2 more papers in the mains. In these 2 papers, we call it as qualificatory. How much your marks you score will not add to your total marks, will not get you a rank in it. But you have to score a minimum marks. It is, one is compulsory English. One more is compulsory regional language, to whichever region you belong. Karnataka people can take Kannada. If you are from Andhra, you can take Telugu. It will be for 300 marks, you just have to score 75. You score 300 on 300, you score 75, won't matter. Whereas in other 7 subjects, higher the score, better the rank you'll get. So this is about mains, totally 9 papers. 7 papers will decide whether you get a rank or not. 2 more papers is just qualificatory nature. Based on your mains score, if you have scored high, you'll get an opportunity for interview. Officially, UPSC calls it as personality test. Many people have a misconception that interview will decide whether you'll become an officer or not. No. Interview is not like reject or selection. Interview is just like a subject. Interview will be for 275 marks. So it's not like interview, you are selected, you are rejected. It's not like a job interview. It's not like that. So finally, if you want to get a rank, what they'll do is interview will be for 275 marks, where they'll test whether this candidate, I have been to interview 3 times, I have got yes, I think Harsha has done a beautiful PPT. So even got a good marks in interview. So it depends on interview, you'll get a mark. Out of 275, you'll be evaluated. So finally, what will happen is your main marks, total score of these 7 papers, and your interview marks will be added. Based on that total score, whether you'll get, as Harsha is showing very beautifully, thanks Harsha for this slide. You see, as I told, essay, 4 general studies paper, Harsha has clearly mentioned what all is there in the general studies paper, which I said, see, for example, general studies 1 is all about Indian heritage, culture, history, geography, and the world and society. General studies 2 is about polity, Indian constitution, governance, social justice, international relations. Then general studies 3 is about technology, economy, biodiversity, environment, security, and disaster management. General studies 4 is a very unique paper which is stretching your ethics, integrity, aptitude, morality, such things. So total, and the optional paper, 2 papers, totally 1,750 marks you'll be evaluated for in the mains, plus 275 marks. Total for 2025, See, last year, when I don't know about this year's score, I have not yet received. Last year for 2025, my total score was 998. I got 240th rank for it. So based on our total score for 2025, you'll be getting a rank or not. It depends on that. So don't be of a misconception. Interview means select, reject. It's not like that. You have to score well in the mains. You have to score well in the interview. So based on that, you get a rank. Sir, what after getting a rank? Many will have that question. After you get a rank, based on your, when we fill the application form, you would have given the options. What is my preference? IAS, IPS, foreign service. Based on your preference, you will give an order. So once you, based on your rank, based on the vacancies, you will be allocated a service. See, for example, last year for 240th rank, I got Indian Revenue Service. This year for my rank, I may get Indian Administrative Service. So according to your rank, you will be getting a service. So this is the overall pattern, how civil service examination works. It is a three-stage process. It will be conducted by Union Public Service Commission. The state civil service, it varies from state to state. It's a three-stage process. The preliminary is just elimination stage. Many people will be eliminated. Around 10 to 15,000 will go to the mains. The most important, in mains, you have to score very high marks and also get a good marks in interview. The combination, what we call as total score, based on that, whether you will get a rank or not. Based on your rank, you will be getting a service. So this is the overall, overall how civil service exam, how, if you want to become an IAS, IPS, what you're supposed to do. This is the overall flow of how the process happens. Over to you, Nalini. I think if they have any questions, anything, or if anyone wants to add, Harsha or sir, you can add.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, I have on behalf of students, I have one question for you, sir.
Yes, please.
As per your experience, typically, how many years do we require to clear civil service examinations?
Okay. See, about myself, this year was my, 2019, which we received recently, we received the results, was my fifth attempt. And previous year also, I got a rank. On the fourth attempt, I was successful. So somewhere, it depends on what is the background studies. Like, for example, being an engineer, it took me a lot of time. I took almost, as actually you only mentioned previously, it took almost 1.5 years or 2 years to give my first attempt to know what is the UPSC on the portal. And first attempt, I couldn't do well. Later, again, I didn't have a grip on my optional. So it depends on the background. But somewhere, I feel more than a year is easily required. And if at all, if they have completed their graduation, all those, if they are good in their basics. So I cannot say exactly how many years is required. So there are many people, see, many times we see people clearing in the first attempt, but we never realize how many years of effort they would have given even before first attempt. I can give you the best example of Tina Davi, 2015, she was my classmate, 2015 batch topper, the first rank. It was her first attempt, but she started preparation just like many of you are listening to this lecture. She started preparation just after her 10th standard itself. She got a very good guidance, so 3-4 years of dedicated effort. She can be a role model for many of you who want to join this program. Like if you see, just after in graduation, she gave her first attempt, became a topper for the whole country in the first attempt itself. That was possible just because she put a lot of effort even before writing the exam. So I can't say exactly how many number of years, but during the graduation, if you can put those 3 years, because you can't give the entire day for it, but if you can give your free time, like in the college, as Harsha already explained, then maybe by the time you complete your graduation, you'll be ready. If you put the right effort in the right direction.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So there are a few questions from the students. They are asking like what they can do after their 10th standard and plus one, plus two, wherein they, as this is a career counseling webinar, and they are asking few questions about it. Is this BSc course helps us to score more in UPSC?
Okay. See, I can totally understand the dilemma which the students and mainly the parents will be in. See, what will happen, what next after 10th? Somewhere I feel it's better you choose the option which where you are interested. Because 10th, whatever you study, plus 1 and plus 2 is not very helpful for your UPSC, whereas degree matters a lot. Yes, if you want, if you think UPSC is your goal, you can go for arts or pure science. It's your choice. But somewhere while selecting degree, even from science, you can come back to arts. That's not a problem. So somewhere I feel it's better you choose wherever you are interested. But during degree, yes, be respectful. UPSC is your goal, then you can go accordingly. For 11th and 12th, I somehow feel wherever is your interest lies, go for that stream.
Yes, another question is that as an aspirant,
okay,
what mistakes usually do they commit and how can an aspirant avoid those mistakes?
Okay, I can easily tell because I have made too many mistakes. Let's be honest, it took so many years. See, as an aspirant, one thing, most important thing many people will do is they never realize what is this exam all about, what is the demand of this exam. They just keep reading from one end to another end, just like how they study for plus two, how they study in their degree. They keep doing the same thing. That you see, always remember, whichever exam you write, whichever competitive exam you write, you need to understand what is the demand of this exam, which means what is the UPSC expecting out of you. That is very, very important. Many times, many aspirants miss that point. And many aspirants, what will happen is, sometimes some few small mistakes will cost them very dear. Like for example, they never select optional in the right manner. That is very, very important. They just choose optional out of overconfidence or like, okay, my friend is studying that optional. They will read on paper, I'll read one more paper. We both will do commenting. That will not work in the basis. Such things will not work in civil services examination. So one more major mistake, which I've seen my own experience or I've taught thousands of students in UCC itself. So one more thing which I've observed amongst the aspirant, what the mistake they do is they fail to select the right optional according to their interest, according to what can get them more marks. And in this journey, they miss major things. Like, for example, this journey is all about testing yourself, like whether you are capable enough, what else can you do. That self-testing they don't do. Like, many times, see, I might have not cleared in few attempts, but I always used to question why I didn't clear. Not cleared again, see, many times they say failure is a stepping stone of success. That is only when you know why you failed. If you don't understand that, then you can't. What will happen? The same mistakes you'll repeat in the next attempt, the same result will get. So always, if I can improve my performance and get two ranks in this process, it's because I always used to correct myself. Never ever be overconfident that, okay, what will happen? I'm a college topper. Won't matter. It won't matter. Even I'm one of the university toppers, but it won't matter. Because if you see the selection score, the first rank candidate will be around 50 to 55%, that's all. So it's don't be of what you are, what is your background. Just give your best. That is what many people will miss. Never think, okay, I was college topper, so I'll easily crack this exam. No, take this exam seriously. Many will take this exam very lightly. Unless you don't get that fear of this exam, you can't crack because you will not be very serious. So these are all standard mistakes, Asha, which many aspirants, few mistakes I might have done, or I've seen thousands of aspirants when I, because of my teaching, I've observed all these mistakes many aspirants do.
Yes. So I could tell the crux is that first understanding the demand, selecting the optionals, self-assessment, and don't be overconfident.
Yes, exactly. Yes. Self-assessment is the key for this field.
Yes, sir. There's another question that how can a non-engineering background student or non-mathematics student prepare for CSAT?
See, CSAT is something which many people have a misconception that only engineering people. In fact, I've seen many engineering graduates failing in CSAT because of their overconfidence. See, CSAT, in the initial year, CSAT was also compulsory. Like, you have to score well in both GS and CSAT to write mains. Presently, it's just you have to score around 67 marks out of 200. So what will happen, even if they're not an engineering graduate, CSAT is not just about mathematics. Because there will be some out of 80 questions, some 20 to 30 questions will be based on your mathematics like HCF, LCM, train problem, all the standard problems. There is an area where we call it as reasoning, verbal logical reasoning, where you don't need any mathematics, it's pure your logic and common sense. Like it may be like who will, like arranging the table or arranging in a row, all those things, or missing, finding the missing number. It's not mathematics, it's logic. And also, even if you're not an engineering graduate, even if you're from arts background, you have a key that is called as comprehension. Comprehension will, wherein there will be a passage you need to answer. Usually some 20 to 30 marks will be from comprehension, 20 to 30 questions. If you score even 20 questions, 2.5 marks, you almost got 50 marks. Just remaining, you have to just score. So somewhere, if that was the case, if an engineering graduate, in that case, many arts students wouldn't have cleared at all. That is the reason government has very well planned it. So even CSAT, with a little practice, even you can solve mathematical questions. It will not be very tough with a little practice, which the institute will always guide you. with a little practice, even the CSAT can be handled very well. So don't be having a fear that, okay, sir, I'm from arts, I'm not good in maths. You don't need a complicated, there is not a simple, see, in all this aptitude question, it's basic arithmetic, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. That's all we do. We will not do any differentiation, integration, all those things, probability, nothing else that you will do. It's basic mathematics, which school mathematics will help you. Also, it's not just about mathematical questions. There are reasoning questions, which is purely based on your common sense, your logic. And also, it is based on pure basic English. Read a paragraph and tell what is the answer, which follows, like what you would have done in your school days also. So don't worry about too much of CSAT, even if you're from arts background, not to worry.
So one more question is, how to remember so much when you read for years together?
Okay.
How can you possibly remember so many stuffs and put it into the words?
Okay. Here, I say there are three aspects. In UPSC or in the civil service exam preparation, the most key thing is, as Harsha mentioned, it's too much of syllabus, I agree. And too many resources. For every subject, there will be n number of books. So you must not just know what to study, you must know what not to study. So you must be very limited in your resources. Many people see, you may end up, everyone will be in a mad chase, running behind. Okay, this book is in any new book in the market, you go and buy this book. That is not the right approach, because reading more number of books will never get you good marks, especially in civil service, because syllabus is so huge. So the first aspect is knowing the right sources, very limited sources. The second aspect is obviously revision. Instead of reading 10 books one time, you read one book 10 times, you'll get a better marks. Because what will happen is, when you do revision, it's a psychology, there is something called as pictorial memory. You just read some 10 times a book. When you close your eyes, you can even, if you mark something there, you can even close your eyes, you'll get a picture of it. This is psychology, pure science. So in that, what will happen is, you will easily get a good revision, some multiple revision, as many times as possible is very much required, because syllabus is very huge. One reading, in the first reading, you'll understand what it is, but you'll not be in a capacity to write the same in exam. Then, sir, how to put it on the paper is all about practice. So for the prelims, we have to practice too many questions, previous year's question papers. And for the mains, you write hundreds or thousands of answers. What will happen when you're writing? You start thinking. So all these, see, one is first exercise is putting it in the memory. The second exercise is taking it from the memory and using it. That is also a difficult exercise. For that, you need to practice. When you write, keep on writing. When you practice the questions, you'll know why you're not able to recollect, which means somewhere the way you studied is not correct. So my suggestion is limited resources, maximum revision, and practice. That will be the mantra for handling such a huge syllabus.
Sir, how did you avoid distractions?
Okay. See, mine was a long journey of 5 attempts in total. In 2013 is when I joined Universal Coaching Center. And yes, that's the age where you see, even your age, you see the students who are listening to it, you'll see a lot of distractions. See, I always feel, I believe in one thing, a great philosopher, Gautam Buddha, says, mind is everything. What you think, you become. So if you want distractions to control, it is here. What I used to do is, I always, even 7 years back, I had written a stick note and hung it on my wall saying that Kaushik HR IAS. I had written it. I was confident that I'll clear this exam. And after 7 years, I have achieved that dream. Which means every day I used to look at it. Okay. I used to self-analyze. No. So it's always one thing is, if you have a strong goal, it's not easy to distract you. Secondly, it's quite natural for human to get distracted. Distraction is not bad, but distraction must not be very long. It's not that, see, when you'll get distraction, if you keep 24 bars on, if you keep studying, that is when you get distraction, you get fatigue, you can't study. Many people think UPS exam is just studies. No, you can have some, like regularly I used to take a break, maybe watching a movie, spending time with family. I used to play sports, such things. And even distraction, I used to take in a positive direction. Even in that break, I used to, like, for example, listening to a music, so it will give me some mental peace. Playing sports is because it is helpful for physical and this thing. And even I used to talk to the friends who will give me positive energy instead of talking to some relatives who may discourage me. And to avoid distractions, to always keep myself motivated, I used to watch all the training videos. Like if you see our academy in Mysore, it is so beautiful. Everyone will want to go there and get trained. It is so beautiful, that environment, that nature, and the way they train. If you're interested in police service, you can see how the police training happens. I used to look at these toppers, how their life is once they clear this exam. So always that used to keep me motivated, and I used to somehow get away from the distraction. So it's quite natural. But somewhere I feel if you have a very supporting friend circle and a family, because that is where you take the distraction. Like for example, even family matters. Like if you are very serious, but the family thinks, okay, come for this one function, what will happen? Automatically they are distracting you. So if you have a supporting family and a very supportive friend group, you can understand what is your dream, and if you, at the end, it is you who can handle it. If you have a very strong goal towards UPSC, you can handle such distractions.
We have a doctor here who is doing MBBS as well as an engineer who is doing BE. So how can he study along with their degree?
Okay, fine. See, basically, it will be medical field, or there are many, even I have many good doctor friends who are in service, my own batchmates. And I myself, I'm an engineer graduate. So my whole point, whatever degree you choose, like it may be difficult for you in the initial days. One thing is, somewhere I feel during your graduation, you get your free time. So per day, you can give some hours. Start with the basics of reading NCERT, the basic subjects what I mentioned already, like history, geography, polity, economy. So during your engineering days itself, or during your graduation itself, if you can do it. And also you can think about what optional you take. For the medical science, for the doctor who has asked this question, there are two best options I can think. One is medical science, that is your own field. That syllabus is very vast. If not, there is one more option. Usually many doctors will choose, that is anthropology. You can choose that also. And maybe if you get time, you can start working on your option. For engineering, one thing is whichever engineering you have, you can take that, or you can take mathematics, or any of the humanities optional. So during your engineering days or during your graduation days, medical, as the doctor was saying, please try to work on the basics. Give ample time for the basics, because basically hari hari madbad, you must not be in a hurry. You need to have a very thorough knowledge of the basic. If, see, for example, any building, if the foundation is weak, how much ever tall you build, how much ever artistically you decorate, whatever interior decoration you do, the building will collapse. That is the reason the basic foundation of a civil service preparation, what we call this fourth subject, give more time on it, prepare accordingly, and also you can choose optional and start preparation.
Students, if you have any other questions, you can raise your questions. And also, if you would like to talk, please raise your hand so that I can unmute you.
If you have any question, you can. There are two options. You can talk to me directly and get it resolved. You can request the question of me, she'll unmute you. If not, you can send your questions in the chat box, and that will be answered by me. If you have any doubt, any question, feel free to talk to me or raise a question in the chat box. I'll answer all your queries.
So we have another student who is Mr. Omkar. He have raised a question stating that his interview is compulsory.
Yes, yes. When I say the three stages, all the three stages, you have to pass through all the three stages. Without the interview, you cannot, how much your means marks you score, you have to go to interview and face the interview board. So all the three stages are compulsory. It's like one gate, from that one more gate, from that one more gate, then you will get IAS. So you can't jump from second gate to the IAS. You have to pass the third gate of interview. So interview is compulsory.
And what are the tips and how can we start studying after 12th? Question from Shashikala Manjunath.
Okay, after 12th, my suggestion is immediate is the basic foundation, which in the college also they can use. NCERT books, which we start with. That is nothing but actually the school textbook, which you would already study, but we wouldn't have studied in the right manner when we study it. That is the whole problem. So immediately you can, first thing is download the syllabus copy from the UPSC. You need to know what all is there. You need to know the exam pattern. So always visit UPSC website, download the syllabus copy. Then you can start reading with the basic NCERT books. And when the college starts, if you join the college and all, you'll be guided how to study it, how to face the exam. But initial preparation, you can start immediately after PU when you get 12, when you get the free time. You can start reading with NCERT, classics to class 12 books.
Okay. And a question from Pavan Kumar, how to improve answer writing skills for mains?
It's purely by practice, Pawan. Purely by practice, because in the first day you can't write the best answer. First of all, there is nothing called the best answer, but you can't write a decent enough answer. I remember my own case when the first answer I had written is on my favorite topic, like international relations, about India and Afghanistan. And a single thing when I showed to my teacher, he just caught it off and saying this answer will get a zero. But you must not. I didn't feel bad for it, but just realized what the mistake I did. I kept regularly practicing. So it's all about practice. It's all about practice. You can, two things you can do. One is practice and also look at others' answers. You can learn from others' answers what good thing they are doing, what bad thing they are doing. You must, like, if they are writing some better aspect, or if they are writing some better, like you can write a flow chart. Oh, I didn't know that in this question I can write a flow chart. Then you can see, okay, for such questions I can write a flow chart, I can write a map, all those things. So always answer writing, see, as the famous phrase goes, it's a skill, answer writing skill. You cannot learn skill like dancing, singing. These are all skills. You can't learn in a single day. You can't learn riding a bicycle in a single day. Many times you'll fall. Then you have to get up, keep practicing. If you don't practice, you can never ride a bike. That is how, for answer writing also, you have to keep practicing. Regular practice can improve your answer writing. Practice and also get it evaluated from a mentor. Right? Because you can't know whether what to improve, what not to write, what to write, how to improve this answer. So you need a feedback from some mentors.
Okay, thank you, sir. And another question from Mandara. Which is the better medium to write UPSC, whether Kannada or English, with Kannada medium background?
Okay, see, Kannada medium background or any other regional medium background. See, UPSC choice put there. UPSC has given you the choice. You can write in any medium which you want. So my suggestion is, if you have a lot of problem in English, tumba samasya ide andre, neevu Kannada medium nalli baribodu. That option UPSC has given. You get resources, but elon kade English medium or siguvanta resources illi sigala. You not get as much resources as for English medium. Sir, illa, my basic English is good, I'll try writing andre, always I suggest write in English medium. So it's purely your choice. UPSC has given you both the options. In prelims, there is no question of mediums because you don't write anything. You just mark into OMR sheet. Whereas in mains and also in interview, if you want, you can give interview also in Kannada. It's purely your choice. So if you are good in basic English, sir, basic English is fine. You don't need to know some Oxford Shakespeare level English. The basic English, if you are good in basic grammar and basic English, you can write in English medium itself. And sir, I don't know, like English and Kabunal card, like very difficult to digest. You can write in your regional medium, Kannada medium. Very good. Option is interview kuda Kannada medium.
Okay. So how many years we should study for IPS after first PUC?
See, as I said, there is no defined number of years. IAS, IPS, again, it's just civil service exam. And there is no separate exam for IPS. It's all one exam. As I said, it's not definite number of years. If someone says, okay, this course, it's not like a course. Okay, you study for 2 years. Like, see, engineering is a professional course. You study for 4 years, you become an engineer. Like BA is a professional course. You study for 3 years, you'll become a BA. Here, it's not like that. It's just that you must be ready for the exam. Some people will study it off in 1.5-2 years. Some people may need 4 years. So it's not a defined, okay, if you study these many years, it's not like a factory. You study these years, go to institute, come out as a IAS officer. It's not like that. It's purely your effort, your hard effort. Any institution can just show you a direction. It's just 5-10% is the role of any institution. It's all about your hard work. The institution can just guide you whether this hard work is going in the right direction or not. So there is nobody can tell you how many years you have to study. It's purely your effort.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste, Ramya.
So my name is Ramya. I am studying first year, sir, this year. I cracked my SLC, sir.
Okay, recently. From where? Elena Matar, from where you're talking?
Sir, I am from Yadgiri, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Okay.
Sir, I want to clear UPSC. So may I get the information about optional subjects?
See, optional, as I said, optional will be 2 papers and 1 subject. So here, the main point will be selecting the right optional. So somewhere, Ramya, don't be in a hurry to select your optional. My suggestion is read the basic books, like history, geography, all those things, or see what degree you will select. There are 2 options. One is, see if you are good in your graduation subjects. See, for me, I was not, though I was one of the toppers, university toppers, somewhere I felt I'm not confident in my engineering subjects. In that case, if you're very confident, say, for example, if you're an agriculture student, if you're very confident, you can take agriculture. If you're BA political science, if you're very confident, you can take political science. So it's like that. If you're confident in your graduation subject, you can take that as optional. If not, look at the basic subjects which are very popular. Better take a popular humanities optional like political science, public administration, geography, sociology, anthropology. These are all options which are very popular. Why I say popular optional is because you get all the materials you want in the market. You get many guidance and you get test series, all those things. So either select an optional where you have a graduation. Since you are still in plus two, mundane even degree mantra, you can select one of those options. In Madre, out of the popular options, see in which you get interest. Without interest, you can't have this option. So always remember, whichever subject you have an interest, you can go for that subject as optional.
Sir, optional will be paper 1 and paper 2, no, sir?
There will be two papers in optional, yes. Prithivan's optional, there will be two papers. Each paper will be for 250 marks.
Sir, literature optionals are also there, no, sir?
Yes, yes. Kannada Sahitya, they have Kannada literature. Every language will have literature. That's a very popular optional also. If you are very much interested in reading Kannada books and analyzing that, you can go for Kannada literature also.
Means, sir, if we select one subject, we should write both the optional, or both optional require a separate subject, sir?
There is only one optional subject. There are two papers. If there is,
okay,
if there is Kannada literature, both paper will be from Kannada literature only. So one subject,
okay, sir.
Two papers.
Yes, sir. That was my doubt, sir.
Only one optional subject, but from that two papers, from that syllabus you'll have two papers.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Master Devil. Good luck.
Hello, sir.
Hello, Nandini. Yes. Tell me where, from where you're talking.
I'm from Ramnagara district, sir.
Okay, okay.
Sir, ನಂದು ಇವಾಗ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಆಯ್ತು, ನಾನು ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್. ಸರ್, ನನ್ನೊಂದು ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಓದ್ಕೋತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಈಗ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಾನು ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ನಾನು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಜಾಯ್ನ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ನಾವು ಐ ಎ ಎಸ್ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ, ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್, ಜಿಯೋಗ್ರಫಿ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಮ್ಗೇನು ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್?
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸಿ ಈ ಬಿ ಎಗ್ ಬಂದ್ರು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಂದ ನಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋಂಗೆ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಚಟಿ ಸರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್, ಅವ್ರ ಹರ್ಷ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್. ಇಲ್ಲೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನೀವು ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಮುಗಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಿ ಎ ಕೂಡ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದ್ ಜನ ಇವಾಗ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ನಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ನೀಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಸೀಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರೋರು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಂದಿರೋರು ಇದಾರೆ. ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿ ಎ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಡನ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಸರ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಓದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಥರ ಏನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಬೇಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಂದಾನೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಸೊ ಬಿ ಎ ನೀವು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರು ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಾನು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನಾನು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿನೇ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಐ ಎ ಎಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ತಪ್ಪಿಲ್ಲ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಮಾಡು ಕೂಡ. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ಹಾಕಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನೀವು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಓದೋ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸಿವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ಗೆ. ಅವಾಗ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಹೊಸದಾಗಿ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು, ಅದೇ ಬಿ ಎ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಓದುವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಕವರ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಸರ್ ಮೇ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಈ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್.
ಸರ್, ಏನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರೆಯೋಕೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್? ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರೆಯಕ್ ಆಗೋದು?
ಯಾರು ಹೇಳಿದ್? ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಗ್ರಾಜುಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಿವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಐ ಎ ಎಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇಂಥದೇ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಡಿಗ್ರಿ, ಎನಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ಡ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ.
ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ವಾ ಸರ್?
ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಮ್ಮ, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್. ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ತುಂಬಾ ಕಡಿಮೆ, ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸಣ್ಣ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಸರ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸಿ ಈಗ ಅವ್ರು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದು.
ಓಕೆ,
ಸಿ ನೋಡಿ ಅಮ್ಮ, ಈಗ ಬಹಳಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಈ ಏನು ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇದಾರೆ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿಕಾಮ್, ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, 70% ಜನ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಅವ್ರು ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ನಿಂದ ಬಿ ಎ ಯಾಕೆ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಕೌಶಿಕ್ ಸರ್ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗೆ ಎನಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಬಿ ಎ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಬಿಕಾಮ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಎಂ ಎ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ನರ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇನ್ನೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡಿ, ಎನಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಈಸ್ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳೋದು. ಖಂಡಿತ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು 3 ವರ್ಷ ಏನು ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕು ಅದನ್ನ ಕಲಿತೀರಾ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಜಾಗ್ರಫಿ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಜಾಗ್ರಫಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಜಾಗ್ರಫೀಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿನೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಲ್. ಬಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಜರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 100 ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಜರ್ 65 ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟೀಸ್. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟೀಸ್ ಇವಾಗ್ಲಿಂದ ಕಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ. ನೀವು ನಾಳೆ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರ ಮೇಲಾದ್ರೂ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಬರೆಯೋಕೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲ್ವಾ? ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟೀಸ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಆಗತ್ತಲ್ವಾ? ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ 3 ವರ್ಷ 4 ವರ್ಷ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮಾಡೋ ಕೆಲಸನ್ನ ಈವಾಗ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿ, ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಜೊತೆಗೇನೆ ನೀವು ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಆ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಜೊತೆಗೇನೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಟೈಮ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಆ ಟೈಮ್ ನಲ್ಲೇ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ 4 ಅವರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನೀವು ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 3 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 4 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಈಸಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಅದರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟರ್ಸ್. ಯುವರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟರ್ ಯಾರೋ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ರು ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಅಥವಾ ಬಿ ಎ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಒಂದ್ ಕಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ. ಅವರು ಬರೀ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗು ಅಥವಾ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬಿ ಎ ಮಾತ್ರ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ನೀವು ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಪರ್ಪಸ್, ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟೀಸ್ ಏನ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಏನ್ ಜಾಗ್ರಫಿ ಇದೆ, ಏನ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಇನ್ಡೆಪ್ತ್ ಆಗಿ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕಲಿತೀರಿ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಈಸಿ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಅದರ್ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ, ನೀವು ಪ್ರತಿ ದಿವಸ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ, ನೀವು ಒಂದು 10 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ, 10 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟರ್ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ನೀವು ಓಡಿ ಓಡಿ ನಿಮ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮಿನಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದ್ರೆ, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆದಾಗ ನೀವು ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಆ ರನ್ನಿಂಗ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತೀರಿ. ಯಾರು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡದೆ ಓಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಓಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಏನ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಿವಿಲ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್. ನೀವು ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಓದ್ತೀರಿ, ಕಲಿತೀರಿ, ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರೀತೀರಿ, ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬೇರೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕ್ವೈರೀಸ್ ಇದೆಯಾ ಅವರದು?
ಸರ್
ಕನ್ವಿನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೇನಾದ್ರು ಬೇಕಂತ?
ಹಲೋ ಸರ್.
ಹಾ ಹೇಳಿ.
ಸರ್ ನಾನು 1ನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಇಂದ 10ನೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವರೆಗೂ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಓದಿದ್ದು. ನನಗೆ 10th ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ, 87% 10th ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಡ್ಸಿದ್ರು. ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ನನಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ. ಇವಾಗ ನಾನು ಬಿ ಎಗ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದಾ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ ಅಥವಾ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಂ? ನನ್ಗೆ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್.
ಆಯ್ತು, ನೀವು ಒಂದ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಈಗ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ಒಂದ್ ಮಾತು, ನನ್ಗೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ. ಆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡಿ, ಯಾವ್ದು ಕಷ್ಟ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇಷ್ಟ ಅಂತ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು ನೀವು. ಕಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೂ ಇಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೂ ಇರೋ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಓಕೆ, ಖುಷಿ ಖುಷಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನನ್ಗೆ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಕಷ್ಟ, ಮ್ಯಾಥ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಷ್ಟ, ಅಥವಾ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ ನಾನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಷ್ಟ, ಅಥವಾ ನನ್ಗೆ ಜಾಗ್ರಫಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಷ್ಟ, ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಷ್ಟ, ಅದು ಆ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಬರಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವುದು ಕಷ್ಟನೋ ಸುಖನೋ ಇದು ತಪಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸ್ಥಳ, ನೀವೇನೋ ಗುರಿ ಸಾಧನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸ್ಥಳ, ನೀವೇನೋ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಚೀವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಸ್ಥಳ, ನೀವು ಅಚೀವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಅಚೀವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಈ ಕಷ್ಟ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಖಗಳು ಎರಡೂ ಬಂದು ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಏನ ನಿನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಆಗತ್ತೇನಮ್ಮ, ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋರ್ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆನೂ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಮರ್ತು, ಎಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಮರ್ತು, ಯಾರು ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಟೀಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲರನ್ನೂ ಮರ್ತು, ನೀವು ಕೇವಲ ಓದಿನ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಗುರಿಯ ಎಡೆಗೆ ನೀವು ಅಚಲವಾದಂತಹ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ನಿರ್ಧಾರವನ್ನು ತಕೊಂಡು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸತತವಾದಂತ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ನೀವು ಯಶಸ್ವಿ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ, ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಮಾತೇ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಸರ್ ಇವಾಗ ನಾನು 10th ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಈಗ 2nd PUC ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಒಂದ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಫೇಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಸರ್, ಅದೇ ತುಂಬಾ ಬೇಜಾರಾಯ್ತು.
ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಬೇಜಾರು ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಿ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು. ನಾನು ಒಬ್ಬರು ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ, ಇಬ್ಬರು ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆಗೆ, ಅವ್ರ ಹೆಸರು ಹೇಳಕ್ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡಲ್ಲ. ಅವರು ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಕಮಿಷನರ್ ಆಗಿ ಮುಂಬೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ನಿಮ್ ತರನೇ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಫೇಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕಾಮನ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅವಾಗ, ಕಾಮನ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದವರು. ನೀವು ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ತೀರಿ, ನಿಮ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಯಾವುದು ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳೋದಿಷ್ಟೇ. ನನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರ್ದಿಯಾನಮ್ಮ, ನಾನ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ಯಾ? ನಿನ್ಗೆ 99% ಆದ್ರೂ ಇರ್ಲಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿನಲ್ಲಿ, 36% ಆದ್ರೂ ಇರ್ಲಿ, ನನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ಯಾ? ಓಕೆ, ನಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಪ್ರಿಲಿಮಿನರಿ, ಸರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಿಲಿಮಿನರಿ ಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ, ನಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಪ್ರಿಲಿಮಿನರಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ಯಾ? ನಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ಯಾ? ನಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಪಾಸ್ ಆದ್ಯಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಒಟ್ಟು ಸೇರಿ ನಿನಗೆ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಮರೀರಿ. ನನಗೆ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದೆ, ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ, ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ, ಈಗ ಫೇಲ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೀವು ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಐ ಎಸ್ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ ಆಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ಗಳೇನು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಐ ಎಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಓಕೆ, ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಆದಂತ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮು. ಆ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಆದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಅದರ ಕಡೆಗೆ ನೀವು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಆದ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿಗೆ ಏನೇನು ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಖಂಡಿತ ನೀವು ಯಶಸ್ವಿ ಆಗ್ತೀರಿ.
ಸರಿ ಸರ್,
ಎಸ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು, ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದು ಕನ್ನಡದ ಮುಂದೊಂದು ದಿವಸ ಅಧಿಕಾರಿ ಆಗೋದನ್ನ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ನೋಡ್ತಾ
ಇರ್ತೀವಿ. ಸರ್, ಕಾವ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ವಿಚ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಯುಪಿಎಸ್ಸಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಬಿಎ?
ನನಗೆ ಮಾಡಿದಾರಾ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರಿಗೆ?
ನಿಮಗೆ ಸರ್, ನಿಮಗೆ. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಯುಪಿಎಸ್ಸಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಬಿಎ, ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್?
ಈ ಕಾವ್ಯ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ. ಅವ್ರ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ.
Yes,
Kavya, see here is, if you go for Karnataka, it is not for the history honors, or it is economic honors, or it is geography honors, or some other things. As Karnataka, as per the Bangalore University, you can go for three subject, even history, political science, geography, okay, or history, political science, economics, like this, okay. You have to study for these three subject. These three subject, you are getting minimum 45 to 50 questions from this humanities, 3 to 4 subject if they add near about 60 questions from the humanities area. Nimge pade pade naav yen helak ishta padtivi andre, once again, see, you are studying BA or you are studying BCom with the economics or some other things, it is related to the UPSC. Now, anyhow, you are deciding your life, you want to become an IAS officer or you want to become an IPS, or you want to become an IRS, Indian Revenue Service Income Tax, or some other, you want to become a government officer, anta neevu enadru decide madidre, if you took as a decision in your life, why not going for some other college, you please come for this college. This is for the niche, this is for the meant for UPSC. Now UPSC IAS preparation bittu, competitive examination preparation bittu, vere yarigu seat kodta illa. This is the hub, this is the right place. I'm strongly recommend you, for my 21 years of service, I am strongly recommend you, this is the right place for doing UPSC examination preparations. Ashtanna nan helaballe. Adrinda, if you are in humanities, it has become easy. If you new engineering aginu, doctor aginu, id madak agala ant ellu helta illa. There are so many doctors also clear this exam, engineers also clear this exam. What is our concept? Kaushik sir, what is his experience is shared with you, and Harsha sir, what is experience shared with you? They are both are the engineers. The Kaushik sir is clear this examination. Instead of that, he is in integrated. He may go for service in the age of 23rd. That is our main motto. We are giving the awareness for the general public. See, if your aim is you want to become an IAS officer, please start now itself. Start in your young age. Don't waste your time. Go for UPSC preparations.
Okay, what are the subjects you are offering in BA LLB?
History, economics, political science, and law. Our all courses, yes, are related to UPSC.
Okay, so among BA and BCom, which would you suggest to select as degree combination?
See, once again, this is your see, if you ask BSc or something, I can give, okay, don't go for this. You can go for either BCom or BA, your wish. You see, if you are from the commerce background of PU, you can go for BCom. You are from the science background of PU, PU matlab 12th, then you can go for the humanities with arts. Anyhow, go for commerce also, it is new. Go for humanities, BA also for new. Instead of you are from the science background, you go for degree along with BA or BA LLB. Yeah, are you from a commerce background already, accountancy and economics, that things are, you know, you can go for BCom background.
Okay, how many attempts, I mean, this is a basic question, how many attempts are allowed for IAS examination, and are there any age limits?
Yes, I think is Kaushik sir is better to answer. Okay. This
see, really, there is both age limit and attempt limit. It is based on the category which you belong. For a general merit, the age limit is 32 years, and the attempts are number of maximum attempts is 6 attempts. And for OBC candidate, the age limit is 35, if I'm not wrong. I think it's 8 or 9 attempts. And for SCST candidate, the age limit is 37 years and there is no attempt limit. You can write any number of attempts until you attain the age of 37. Yes, there is age and attempt limit across multiple categories.
Okay, what is the best subject to take after 10th to be IAS? How many years we have to get trained? Question from Richa.
Okay, as I think answered already. See, there is nothing like how many years of training. There is not. It's not like a factory, as I said. It's not about how many years of training. It's about how much hours you put, how well prepared you are. So you can't say, okay, you study for 5 years, you'll become an IAS, or you study for 2 years. It's up to you. It's about your effort. So, and which subject you want to take. Yeah, see, for the number of attempts, Harsha is sharing. For general, 32 years and 6 attempts. For OBC, 35 years and 9 attempts. And now there is a new category called economically reconstruction. It's same like general. For SCST, 37 years and there is no listing. Number of attempts, there is no listing. And if there is someone who is physically handicapped, physically disabled, 42 years. And this thing, in that, whatever category they belong, accordingly, the number of attempts. And regarding number of years of training, there is no, I'll not say, okay, you'll be, it's not training, it's something like guidance, that's not training. So it's not like degree, okay, study for 4 years, you'll become an IAS. It's basically your effort. If you put very good effort, by the time you come out of graduation, you can write the exam and clear the exam. I gave you the example of Tinadabi. So it's all your this thing. And regarding the stream, I feel for the plus one, plus two, you can select the stream which you are interested. For degree somewhere, I feel humanities degree will help you more for civil service preparation.
Okay. So there's a question from Sujata Nair. She have asked, Kaushik sir, this question is for you. So she asked whether which books you referred, newspaper and for current affairs, which newspaper you referred.
Okay, regarding books, the most basic book is NCERT. Other than that, when you come to the classes, you know the respective faculty, they'll tell if you want to refer other books. The most basic book everyone will refer is the NCERT books. And regarding newspapers, always it is the Hindu newspaper. Most every aspirant will refer the Hindu. So even I used to refer the Hindu newspaper. It's not that other newspapers are not good, other newspapers are also good. But somewhere Hindu is more focused about analytical part of it. So I used to refer Hindu newspaper. Jotege, once I was comfortable with Hindu, I used to also read Indian Express. Not the new Indian Express which we get in Karnataka, the Indian Express which we get online. I used to refer that also. But basic newspaper, you can even read one newspaper that is sufficient, is the Hindu newspaper. Yes, Rajkumar.
Sir, this is from Andhra Pradesh State, Anantapur district, sir.
Anantapur, where in Anantapur, Rajkumar?
Hindupuram, sir.
Hindupur, okay. I've been to all the spaces many times. That's the reason I asked. Okay, I have family members there. Okay, fine. What's your question, Rajkumar?
I'm from science background, sir.
Okay, what you are studying?
Science background, MPPC, sir.
Okay.
Sir, my question is, if we take BTEC, there will be backup option, if not UPSC, sir. But if we take BA, what will be the backup option without UPSC, sir?
Okay, that's a very valid question. Later, I think Iman Shetty sir can speak about that. See, that's why because, if you're taking yes, I understand your concern. Sir, if you take BA, if you take BTEC, if I don't clear exam, at least I can go and work in IT companies. That is what your whole point. Correct, Rajkumar?
Sir, this is not only my question, sir. My father asked me, my interest okay. was gone towards BA, sir, but my father telling to take BTEC, sir. So what will be the backup option if to be?
I'll tell you. Firstly, yes, you are saying in the BTEC, if you take BTEC as optional, one thing, if you don't take civil services, you think you can go to some this thing. But if you take BA as optional also, one thing is, it's not just about civil service exam, not just IAS exam. Even if you don't clear this exam, there are many government exams where you will be eligible. Like, for example, you can write APPSC exams, you can write, it can be a sub-inspector exam, revenue inspector exam. So there are many. If you want to be in a government job, most of the government employment, it may be FPA, HDA, whatever is your state government, or there is something called SSC. You have to clear that exam twice. So you'll be eligible. You can, if you prepare for one civil service exam, you can write almost every government recruitment exam. That will be one aspect of looking at it. I think Harsha or Shetty sir can put more light on it.
Okay.
Harsha sir, you anyway you are experienced. You can answer, I guess.
Yes. So one thing I would like to tell you: don't keep Plan B. Okay. So keep Plan A. Okay. Because if you are confident, then obviously you can clear the examinations.
First. Yes, sir.
Second thing, yes. What if you could cannot?
Yes, sir.
See, civil service is not the only option actually. Now yes, you will be having many other examinations like. There are around 1.5 lakh. Okay.
Yes,
so grade B and grade C and grade A jobs
yes,
in government services, which offer you better pay than the civil services. Okay. Sorry. Your company, that is private companies. Okay. So nowadays, I think you've got to know that I think you might be having an awareness that most of the people are going there to government jobs.
Yes, sir.
So why? Because see, government is offering a better pay than the private sector, as well as you'll be having a respect, dignity, everything. The thing is, when you prepare for civil service examinations, you're not preparing for only one exam, you'll be preparing for multiple examinations.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Wherein you can crack one or the other exams, unless you must be serious. You need to be serious. Okay, if you're not serious, then obviously you're not able to make out anything.
Yes, sir.
Right. Yes. So this is what I can add. And in our college, we are preparing you not only for civil services, in 3 years, you will be having a time. So in 3 years, we are giving you a holistic approach. The
yes,
you know, purpose of the college itself is after 3 years of your graduation, the student must crack one or the other government job, prestigious government job, whether it is civil services, whether it is Telangana Public Service Commission, whether it is Karnataka PSC or banking or SSC, any exam.
Thank you, sir.
Good luck, sir.
Jayachandra.
Ah.
Yes, you have asked a question stating that
yes.
When he can write. Being a BA LLB student,
yes,
when
see,
he can crack
civil service. Earlier it was BA and LLB is different for 5 years course. Now 3 and 2. Now it is a 5 years course in all over India. See, thing is. If those who are going for degree, usually, what is your experience, they all are giving shortage of 3 months and other things. They are also writing the fourth year, but you can write in the final year. Those who are in BA LLB, they can write in final year. Okay, thank you.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I am from Gulbarga district. Actually, just I completed my second PSC, sir, who is willing to crack NEET 2020.
Okay.
If I crack NEET 2020, I'll go in MBBS field. Actually, it's all know that MBBS is one of the toughest field. But after completing MBBS, and it's took also it takes 5 years to complete MBBS, and another 3 years for MD.
Mm-hmm.
Already, it's one of the long term.
Mm-hmm.
But it's very lengthy, to crack UPSC.
Okay, see, for the medical optional, I think from Gulbarga, right district, I can give you the right.
Yes.
Previously, there was assistant commissioner, my very good friend, by Gopal Krishna. And presently, the assistant commissioner of Gulbarga is Dr. Akash. Both are from Bangalore Medical College, have completed MBBS. So, those guys didn't go for master's degree immediately after. I have, like Dr. Nagarjan Boda, this year there is Dr. Virat Reddy. There are many doctors who are cracking this exam. So many people, usually what they do immediately after their MBBS, they come for the civil service preparation. There are even, I have an example of one of my friends who is in my batchment in Indian Revenue Service, my name is Dr. Srikanth, he is MS orthopedic. So there are people who pursue masters also and do. Somewhere I think instead of going for masters, if your goal is to prepare for civil service, if you are very much passionate about medicine also, you can take up MBBS. And then after MBBS, you can give the civil service again. There are many doctors. For example, in your district, your assistant commissioner by name Dr. Akash, he's my batchmate. He's a very good friend of mine. He's from Bangalore Medical College. So that is doable, totally doable.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good luck. I'm able to hear you, Pratik.
Sir, no, Pratik, I'm Bangalore. I'm talking about second PO.
Okay.
Yes, sir. I'm second PO. ಸೊ ಇವಾಗ ನಾನು ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಬಟ್ ನನಗೆ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಬಿ ಎ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮನೇಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಅಪ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೀವು ಬರೀ ಐಎಎಸ್ ಗೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಐಪಿಎಸ್ ಗೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಒಪ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ ಸರ್. ಈಗ ನೀನ್ ಐಎಎಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಐಪಿಎಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀನ್ ಅದೆಂಗ್ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ, ನಿನ್ ಇದೆಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ, ಒಂದ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಅಪ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಹಂಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್. ಅದು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ ಸರ್?
ಅವಾಗಲೇ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಗೇವನ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಯಾರೋ ಒಂದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ಒಂದು ಒಪ್ಕೋತೀನಿ. ಸಮ್ವೇರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕಪ್ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಪ್ರೈವೇಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಬಿ ಎ ಗೆ, ಇವನ್ ದೇ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಇದೆ ಬಿ ಎ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಗೆ. ಬಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿ ಎ ಗೆ ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಚಾನ್ಸಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಬರೀಬಹುದು. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್, ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಇದು ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಈ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಸರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಬೆಟರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆನ್ಸರ್.
ಸರ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇದೆ ನಂಗೆ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಆಂಥ್ರೋಪಾಲಜಿ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅಂತ ಚೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಬಟ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದ್ರಿಗೆ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರ, ಹೇಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ?
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸಮ್ವನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸರ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟಿ ಸರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್
ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಸಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, 1 ಇಯರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೈನ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್. Like because you will not be having any idea regarding first of all the pattern of the exam, syllabus, previous year question papers, fine, and as well as you will not be having an idea regarding what subject must be given what weightage, fine. So first year you will be trained for the foundation, and from the next year we will start with the optional subject. Anthropology is optional subject you are speaking, if I am not wrong, right?
Yes sir.
From second year, so we will make a segregation with the students. Those have taken political science as an optional subject, those have taken anthropology as an optional subject. Okay, so first of all, we will give orientation, because see, right? Now you have taken optional as a anthropology. Okay, yeah. On based on what you have taken optional as anthropology,
sir? Based on my interest, sir.
Right, so you will get the orientation in the college for first year. Okay, you will be exposed with many subjects. Who knows, after first year you might change the optional subject. Let us think that you will keep anthropology as an optional subject itself. Okay? But from second year, we will start training you the optional subjects. Okay, that is third, fourth, fifth and sixth semester. Okay? So with it, just as well as with the answer writing.
ಸರ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಇದೆ, ನಾನು ಕೌಶಿಕ್ ಸರ್ ನ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು, ಇದೊಂದು ಕ್ಯೂರಿಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನಂಗೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಲೋ ಸರ್, ಇವಾಗ ಆಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ 45 ಬಂತು ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ಗೆ, ಅವರು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಂದಾನೆ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇದು ಉತ್ತರ ಪ್ರದೇಶ ಕ್ಯಾಡೆ ಅಲಾಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು, ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಆಕಾಶ್ ಅವರು 78 ಬಂತು ಆಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಕ್ಯಾಡೆ ಅಲಾಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ಅದೇ ತರ ರೋಹನ್ ಜಗದೀಶ್ ಗೆ 224 ಬಂತು, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಕ್ಯಾಡೆ ಅಲಾಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಏನ್ತ್ರೂ ಬೇಸಿಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಈ ತರ ಕ್ಯಾಡೆ ಅಲಾಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ
ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ರೋಹನ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್. ಸಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಲ್ಲೂ ಅಗೇನ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕೆಟಗರಿ ವೈಸ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಡರ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ವೇಕೆನ್ಸಿ ಪ್ರತಿ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಈ ತರ ವೇಕೆನ್ಸೀಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಇನ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ 45th ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇದ್ರು, ಅವ್ರು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಜನರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಒಂದೇ ಸೀಟ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು, ಅದು ರಾಹುಲ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು 17th ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್, ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಸಿಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಕಾಶ್ ಒಂದು ಓಬಿಸಿ ಸೀಟ್ ವೇಕೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಆಕಾಶ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು. ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ರೋಹನ್ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಸೀಟ್, ಅವ್ರ ಜನರಲ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರಿಂದ ಆತರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ಲಿ ಲಕ್. ಅದು ಏನ್ ವೇಕೆನ್ಸಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ವೇಕೆನ್ಸಿ ಕೆಟಗರಿ ವೈಸ್ ನಮಗೆ ಆ ವೇಕೆನ್ಸಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಈ ವರ್ಷ ನನಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಒಂದ್ ವೇಕೆನ್ಸಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಲಕ್.
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಸರ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್.
ಯೆಸ್ ಯೆಸ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟಾಕ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಹಿಯರಿಂಗ್.
ಸೋ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲೂರ್.
ಓಕೆ,
ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೇಕನ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ?
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಯೆಸ್, ಓಕೆ.
I have doubts, sir. How many optional subjects are available in our college, sir?
You mean how many optionals will they be offering? I mean, once you...
Yes, sir.
Doubt, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
I think someone from management can answer this. Yes.
Harsha, sir, you can answer, I guess.
Yes, sir. See, Chaudhary, first of all, the orientation will be given to you for optional subjects. That is one thing. Second thing is, see, there are around... You know, like more than 26 optionals, which subjects will be more than 30 optional subjects.
Okay, sir.
You are taking which course in our college?
BA sir.
BA, right? Okay.
Yes,
so I assume that you will actually take optional subject either from history, economy, or political science. Okay, what is your actually this thing? Is it HCP or HGP?
Sir?
Have you taken history, geography, political science, or history, economics, political science?
History, economic, and political science, sir.
Okay. So obviously, when you have taken 3 years of the course, that is history, economics, and political science, okay, so you will be going with the humanities subject itself, right? Either it is history, or else economy, or else political science, or else the subjects which are derived from these subjects, like political science, you can also read public administration, okay? So as well as you can take anthropology. Apart from it, you cannot go to any other subjects which is not at all having any, you know, relevance in reading general studies, right? You cannot take mathematics as your optional subject. You cannot take commerce as your optional subject, right? So all these subjects which I have mentioned, like history, geography, okay, political science, public administration, anthropology, these optional subjects, we have orientation, including Kannada literature also.
Right. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, and languages which are available, sir?
Like
Kannada, Sanskrit.
I think Kannada is available. I think Nalini, madam.
Yes, sir. Sir, English, Kannada, Hindi.
English.
First language is English. Second language, either they can offer Kannada or Hindi.
Yes,
sir, good evening. So actually I'm a dental student, final year student, sir. So I have a question. Yes, sir.
Okay.
In Chitradurga, sir.
Chitradurga.
So I'm from Gulbarga, but I'm studying in Chitradurga, sir.
Okay, fine.
So I have a doubt on time management, sir, because I have suffered a lot of during my practice. So I mean, posting time, I have a lot of problem from time management. So can you suggest for time management for future, sir? For IAS preparation.
Most important thing is, it's not just hard work. What we need is smart work. So even I was working before and I have tried this exam.
Yes,
you were saying something, sorry.
So even I want smart work, sir, because for this dental is 5 years, no, sir. I don't want to waste the time in giving a 2 to 3 times exam. So I want to crack in a first attempt only, sir. So
can you suggest? One thing is, I think you'll have some vacation or some leave. Whenever possible, try to cover with your basic knowledge. That is your NCERT.
Yes,
along with that, I was a person who used to use technology a lot. So when you don't have patients, when you're practicing or you don't have classes, what I used to do, like when I was traveling in the cab itself, I used to read my newspapers. And while returning, during return journey, I used to watch some YouTube educative videos. So also, I used to use internet so much that everything was in mobile. So whenever I get free time, I used to use my mobile and try to get those information. So somewhere, one thing is you need to know how much time you are getting and plan accordingly.
Okay.
Second thing is, use of technology will help you a lot in cutting down the number of hours. For example, if you're not able to find too much of time, you can listen to some recorded audio while you're traveling. Or you can use, even if you get 10 minutes of free time, you can watch an educational video on YouTube. So I used to do such things when I was working. So that can save a lot of time for you.
Okay, sir.
You can start preparing now itself by starting NCERTs. Once you're out of your BDS, once you've completed it, maybe if you're ready, you can write. If not, you can take a break of 1 year, complete the entire thing, what you're left with, then you can give your
attempt. Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. Because I have suffered a lot of problem for this, sir. That's why I asked, sir.
That's the reason. Just know what is the syllabus and have your own timetable. Because I can't tell you how you manage it, because I don't know what is the time you get. So based on your time, no, where all you can get free time. Try to squeeze maximum free time where all you get. Try to use that in the right direction. Have your own timetable and plan accordingly.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Good luck, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. I hope we have answered most of the queries of the students. And so I hope this is the time to wind up the session. And I would like to thank Kaushik sir for spending his time with us and for all his suggestions and views and his experiments. He have shared all his experience and motivated most of the students who were present in this webinar. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us on this platform.
You're welcome.
Yes, sir. Yeah, and even Harsha sir and even Mr. Upendra Shetty sir, thank you very much for sharing most of the details and most of the information for the students. And I would like to thank to all the students who participated in this webinar. I hope it was very much helpful for you all. And also I have shared the website link. You can also visit our website, that is universalinstitutions.com. And I have shared the contact numbers as well in the chat box, which you can, for more details, you can contact us if you have any doubts or any clarifications regarding admissions or any other doubts regarding your UPSC preparations. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you all. Take care. Be safe.
Welcome, welcome ma'am. Yeah. And also thank you, sir. You for being wonderful host.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Okay. Thank you, so, shall we wind up, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Kaushik sir, once again, thank you so much.
Welcome.